In the year 2018, 23-year-old Daniel Miller was in the parking lot, hanging out with his four other friends in front of the 7-Eleven convenience store. Daniel, the victim, did not have his own car, so he borrowed his on-and-off-again girlfriend's car without her permission. Around 9 o'clock, a civilian videotaped a car racing into the parking lot where a furious woman rushed out and approached the victim. Another female, who was later identified as Olivia Watson's best friend Alexis Hunt, exited the car from the driver's side and they both approached the group. Alerted by the commotion, Daniel turned to see his girlfriend Olivia stomping towards him. He then sees a large tire iron in her hand. Olivia begins to strike the victim repeatedly. It can be seen from the videotape that Daniel was trying to block her attacks before using force to push her away and grab the weapon. She steps back before turning around to return to the car and flee. He then pushes her, sending her to the ground hard. When police arrive, Daniel and Olivia are taken into custody. It is noted the couple has a history of a volatile relationship. Daniel has a laceration across his cheek, bruised ribs, and a fractured finger, among other defensive wounds. Olivia sustained a broken wrist and skinned knees from her impact with the ground. Charges are laid. The parties to this crime are Daniel Miller, Olivia Watson, and Alexis Hunt. Daniel and Olivia are both charged for their offenses and victims of the crime themselves. Alexis is charged as a party to the offense. The issue in this case are that Daniel had taken Olivia's car without her permission. Olivia assaulted Daniel with a tire iron, resulting in bodily harm. Daniel, in defense, pushed Olivia, resulting in her falling onto the ground. And lastly, Alexis influenced Olivia's decision, prompting harm to Daniel, and drove her to the scene of the crime. The following will outline the elements of all the offenses committed in this crime, the ways in which the written law is interpreted as unclear with relation to supplementary cases dealing with similar charges and offenses, and the defenses each accused will or could possibly use throughout the trial.
Daniel will be charged with one count taking a motor vehicle or vessel or found therein without consent, and one count of aggravated assault. Taking a motor vehicle or vessel or found therein without consent. Daniel, without Olivia's consent, borrows her vehicle. He drives it over to the 7-Eleven parking lot to meet up with a group of his friends. Section 268 of the Criminal Code, aggravated assault. Daniel, without consent, forcefully pushes Olivia to the ground. The forceful push causes Olivia to have a broken wrist and skinned knees from the impact of the fall. Olivia will be charged with one count of possession of a dangerous weapon, one count of assault causing bodily harm, one count assault with a weapon, and one count of aggravated assault. Possession of a weapon for dangerous purpose. Olivia uses the tire iron that she had stored away in Alexis's vehicle to strike Daniel multiple times. Section 267 of the Criminal Code, assault with a weapon. Olivia approaches Daniel aggressively. She then begins to strike him multiple times with the tire iron intentionally. Section 267 of the Criminal Code, assault causing bodily harm. Olivia strikes Daniel multiple times without consent. Section 268 of the Criminal Code, aggravated assault. Olivia's assault with the weapon causes Daniel to have a facial laceration as well as fractured finger and multiple other defensive wounds. Alexis will be charged with one count of party to an offense. Section 21 of the Criminal Code, party to an offense. Everyone is a party to an offense who actually commits it, does or omits to do anything for the purpose to commit, abets any person in committing it. Alexis is promoting the harm to an individual. She is also holding prejudice towards Daniel, and she also intends for harm to come to him. Under Section 21B of the Criminal Code, Alexis omits to do anything while Olivia is assaulting Daniel.
To have a comprehensive understanding of how the case was interpreted, let's consider a few case laws that is applicable to the scenario and section of the Criminal Code. With Daniel's conviction of theft, let's keep in mind Section 322. In R versus Richards, 1972, a man stole a police officer motorcycle while being issued a ticket as a joke. He was charged with theft. The Court of Appeal later charged with a lesser offense of joyriding. In Section 322, a person commits theft when, with the intent to steal anything. Although different events occurred for the both parties, which is Richard and Daniel, both did not have the intention of stealing. You may be wondering how to prove Daniel's intention to return Olivia's car. For starters, it is unlikely, not impossible, for someone who is guilty of theft to go hang out with friends openly knowing you can be spotted. Your first initial response will be to hide the vehicle. Maybe this isn't enough. How about the fact that Olivia never reported the car stolen? Not convinced? How did Olivia know where Daniel was? After further investigation, no text messages or call log was later found. The complexity of the relationship between Daniel and Olivia played a substantial part in the decision of his conviction, as it is assumed that this is not the first time Daniel has taken Olivia's car without her permission. Section 2 defines theft as everyone on who, without the consent of the owner, takes a motor vehicle with intent to drive or use it or cause it to be driven or used is guilty of an offense punishable on summary conviction. Based on this definition alone, one may assume that Daniel will be convicted of theft. However, you have to consider other sections like section 322 with the intent to steal. This is what separates theft from a joyride conviction. With joyriding, Daniel will also be charged with assault causing bodily harm, while Olivia will be charged with assault causing bodily harm and assault with a weapon. Shocked about the results? Yes, so was I. After looking at R versus McNeil 2012 case law, a change in charges, as my first initial thought was aggravated assault for Daniel. Let's break this down. Section 265, a person commits an assault when, without consent of another person, he applies force intentionally to that other person, directly or indirectly. Now, based on this, Daniel will be charged with assault, right? Well, wrong. Here's why. Daniel intentionally applied force, causing Olivia to fall, which resulted in her sustaining a broken wrist and bruised knees. Because Olivia sustained some type of bodily harm, Daniel should be convicted of assault causing bodily harm as opposed to just aggravated assault. Section 267 reiterates this fact. Olivia, on the other hand, would also be convicted with assault causing bodily harm and not aggravated assault because of what wounded knees. Let's track back for a minute. In order for someone to be convicted of aggravated assault, they must fulfill one of these forms in section 268. Now you're probably asking what type of an injury is considered wound. From past cases like R versus Visitant, R versus Hilderman, and R versus McDonald, all injuries were something that changed a person's life altogether. For example, based on injury sustained after an assault, someone loses the ability to hear, see, or jaw reconstruction, which requires screws in order for the person to reach a normal state. So in essence, bodily harm is a lower injury and aggravated assault is a higher on the spectrum, where these injuries endanger or disfigure or maim or wound. To distinguish bodily harm from wounding, when injuries alone is not making it clear, the permanence or long-lasting effect of the injuries will assist. When it comes to someone being a party to a crime, Section 21 is considered. Looking at R versus Rue 2012 case law, Graham was kidnapped at gunpoint. Vu, along with five others, were convicted of kidnapping and unlawful confinement. However, there was no evidence to show that Vu knew the time or participated in the abduction. Sam Vu became now an accessory to kidnapping because of his knowledge and participated by the purchasing of duct tape. Under Section 21, he will be convicted of party to a crime. This will follow the same precedent for Alexis. Although Alexis did not participate in the physical attack of Daniel, she was, however, the person that drove Olivia there, along with prior knowledge of the event.
To commence an analysis of the case, let's begin with Daniel Miller.
He is charged under Section 264 of the Criminal Code as he inflicted grievous bodily harm upon Olivia.
Daniel's defense to this is that by provoking a fight, Olivia consented to any harm that could occur during the interaction. Furthermore, it is Daniel's right to self-defense. Self-defense is the use of equal force to deter an assault. However, a presenting issue of this defense is that when he enacted his motion of self-defense, Olivia's back was turned. This can be considered as her abandoning the altercation. This means that Daniel was no longer in harm's way and had no reason to believe he was going to be harmed. Therefore, self-defense is not a fitting defense for this charge.
Daniel's second charge is joyriding under Section 335 of the Criminal Code. His defense to the charge is that he assumed consent from Olivia. This is due to the fact that he had previous prolonged consent to utilize the motor vehicle and had every intention to return it to its rightful owner in the same condition as when he found it, much like every other time he borrowed it. This defense is sound as he had previous permission to use Olivia's car, and that permission was not revoked.
In continuation of the case analysis, let's shift focus to Olivia.
Olivia Watson is the instigator of the assault. Like Daniel, she is also charged with assault. However, her assault charge extends to assault with a deadly weapon.
During Olivia's assault on Daniel, she struck him with a tire iron. This resulted in injuries that constitute grievous bodily harm.
In Olivia's defense, she asserts that Alexis Hunt counseled her in the event and encouraged her to attack Daniel. According to Section 22 of the Criminal Code, Olivia maintains that Alexis encouraged her to commit the criminal act. Another aspect of her defense is that she did try to leave the scene. She did turn around during the altercation to go back to her car. Therefore, she asserts that she was abandoning her intentions before severe grievous bodily harm was inflicted upon Daniel. The issue with the defense is that when she notes that she abandoned her intentions, she was already the vast majority of the way through the assault. Therefore, she already inflicted grievous bodily harm upon Daniel.
Lastly, we analyze Alexis.
Alexis is charged under Section 22 of the Criminal Code. She's charged with counseling and abetting Olivia. In defense of Alexis, she maintains that she had no knowledge of the interaction that was about to occur between Olivia and Daniel. Despite how passionate Olivia was at the fact that her car was missing, Alexis maintains that she did not know the fight was going to be physical and therefore is claiming willful blindness towards the possible outcomes of the interaction.